the next day, which is also Lindy's birthday, and we just went out for her birthday lunch, and when we got back to Holiday, the swell is coming through prickly, and it's insane. Boats are rolling all over the place. There's no way we could sleep or enjoy an evening here. So, here we go. Look at this. So, we're picking up the anchor, and we're gonna move to another bay, back over to Woburn and see if it's better. I feel bad for Lindy on her birthday this happening, but hey, we gave it a try. This is definitely not somewhere to stay. Good riddance, Prickly Bay. Whoa. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna come back there again. Well, Lindy, your birthday's had a little hitch.
Yeah, it'll be okay. The biggest problem is gonna be cleaning up that kombucha. We may be in the market for some new boat books.
Yeah, so the kombucha just went everywhere. All over the shelf, all over the books. I can't believe that anybody is staying right now. I would think every single person would leave. Oh well. Okay, so here we go. It's a rainy day, but it's Lindy's birthday, so we are gonna go find us a nice place and have a fun evening. Wow. Just gotta get around Prickly Point. It's probably gonna be pretty nasty out here.
Yeah.
But, oh well. It's only like 3 miles, so we'll make it.
After a month in Woburn, a month at Port Louis Marina, and then a month in Carriacou, we had really hoped to spend some time in Prickly Bay. It's near the medical college, and there are a lot of cool restaurants and hangouts for the students. But it was too uncomfortable for our tastes, so back we went to Woburn for Lindy's birthday and the final month or so of hurricane season.
All right, birthday girl. Got you in a new anchorage.
Yeah.
This is
a lot better.
Much better. Let's see here. So this time in Woburn, we're back here kind of hidden behind Hog Island to keep us out of the swell. Rogers Beach Bar is just around that corner. Clark's Court back that way. We're kind of just out from Whisper Cove, and then over there is Calvinie Cut where we anchored for the first month. So yeah, very still, much better than Prickly Bay. Yeah. All right, what is it time to do now, Lindy?
Now I've got to clean up the kombucha.
We got the mess straightened and the kombucha cleaned up and had a wonderful birthday dinner aboard Holiday in the comfortable waters of Woburn Bay. The next month or so was really just a waiting game for the most active part of hurricane season to end, and also to see what sort of travel restrictions would exist due to coronavirus when it was safe to start moving north again. By this time, Grenada had been coronavirus free for some months, and we felt safe moving around and most places were open. We wanted to see some parts of Grenada that we hadn't seen yet, so we headed up to Whisper Cove Marina, where we were meeting Shademan for an island tour. Shademan is a famous taxi driver in Grenada with the cruisers. He's always there to help and with information, and announces on the radio every morning his shopping bus trips.
Look at that. Mm-hmm. There's Port Louis.
That's Port Louis. Right in front of you, that's a prison right on the edge there.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. You got 2 points down there. One is called Point Celine. The further one is Point Celine. Mm-hmm. And that is where the international airport is, and it's also the very end of the island, that's the tail of the island down there. Then the second point is called Quarantine Point. Back in the 1800s, then there was leprosy. That's where they used to bring the people and quarantine them.
Oh.
And this, let me tell you about this. This you can, it's good for seasoning of your meat.
Yeah.
It's also a medicine. You have a cold, a little fever, a little ache, you just draw this and drink it.
Huh. And it just grows wild.
Look at how it grew
wild.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Big time.
Big time, they call that.
Awesome.
Big time. Mm-hmm. I like it.
Yeah, that's nutmeg.
Look at there.
And nutmeg is one of the most important spices in Grenada. You just lay wipe hold some and then you pick some again.
Okay,
have a smell of it.
What is that?
Okay, that is called kashmi. We make soap and perfume of it. This is the same thing I have right there.
Oh, okay. It's like an air freshener.
Yeah.
Call it the post-scan photo.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Arenage.
Cricket stadium, and the other one is the athletic stadium. And up on the hill where you see the white tanks and the solar system, that is our electricity power station, where we generate 230 volts from some diesel engines from England. They got five big engines in there that supply the whole island, so they run them simultaneously.
Next, we left the city area and headed over the mountains and Grenada's beautiful rainforests. On the other side of the mountains, we came to a cool historical site. Grenada's original airport opened in 1943. Through the ensuing decades, Grenada became part of the Cold War struggle between the United States and the Soviet Union. Some relics from this era still remain. A couple of Cuban and Soviet airplanes left after the U.S. intervention and invasion in 1983, when subsequently the main airport was moved to Point Salines, where it is now.
The airstrip?
Yeah. Now we use it for drag racing.
Really?
Yeah.
Drag racing, well, let's see what this thing's got. No.
Not when you in it.
Near the airport was River Antoine Rum Distillery, one of the oldest distilleries in the Caribbean, with the oldest water wheel that still functions and presses the cane. Their rum has such a high alcohol content that it is flammable and cannot be taken on airplanes. Surrounding the facility are piles of used sugarcane, and also fields where the sugarcane is grown. Midway through the tour, Shademan dropped us off at beautiful La Sagesse Beach for a bit of relaxing before continuing on. As the day wore on and we neared the southern bays, Shademan took us through some of the exclusive neighborhoods with large estates on the peninsulas with stunning views that create the southern bays. Hog Island, Holidays right back up in there, Calvinny Island, and Trinidad's down that way. It was an awesome tour showcasing the beauty and variety Grenada has to offer. Another highlight of our last months in Grenada was...
We're gonna do our first hash. A hash is like a walk slash run. It's a group activity and it just goes through the mountainsides of Grenada.
Yeah, we'd always heard about people doing hashes, and we've been wanting to do one ourselves. It's supposed to be a crazy time. We're supposed to get really muddy and dirty and sweaty.
Hot and sweaty.
And then there's a big party at the end. So, yeah, we'll see what it's like.
Hey, look, I've got shoes on. I think it's probably the first time I've worn shoes in, I don't know.
The Hash House Harriers is an international group of non-competitive running social clubs. An event organized by a club is known as a hash, or run. One or more members go out in the wilderness and mark a trail with bits of paper or flour. The trail includes false trails, shortcuts, dead ends, checkbacks, and splits, just to keep things interesting.
The blobs of shredded white and yellow paper will take you away from here, will lead you on a trail, and if you follow the trail properly, it will bring you right back here. When we start, we say on on. On on means get moving. So you'll look at where everybody else is going and you go off on that path. If you get to a circle is a checkpoint. It means that the trail goes off in more than one direction. Only one is correct. If you meet an X, you're on the wrong path. You have to go back to the circle and find the blobs going off in a different direction. If you hear somebody shout on back from ahead of you, that means they got to an X, they're on the wrong trail. You need to go back to the circle and keep on going in another direction. If you're not sure if you're on the right track, you shout out, are you? If the person ahead shouts on back, turn around, you go back to the circle. If you hear on, you're on the right track, you keep on going. If somebody gets to the circle before you, they might shout out checking, which means they're checking, right?
Oh, here we go. Everybody just turned around.
Oh, I just went down for the second time.
Yeah! More mud. Now that we're clean, we can get dirty again.
Yep. Hey, the sunshine!
We got muddy again, but I enjoy the water.
Yeah. Wow.
The bad thing is we have no idea how far along we are and how much of this is left.
Yeah.
But we'll make it out eventually. Wow. Oh look, more mud. Mangoes. Oh, look at that big guy. Wow. Oh my gosh. There's the mango tree.
We've got to be getting close.
We can hear the music at the parking lot, so can't be too far away. Oh yeah! Oh look! Woohoo! We did it!
I have to say, the event was much more difficult than I had anticipated, and I was super proud of Lindy for completing it. We were out there for over a couple of hours, really managing some difficult terrain in muddy conditions. It felt great to get cleaned up and eat a giant plate of Grenadian oil down. The last great highlight of the end of our time in Grenada was a hike to Mt Carmel waterfalls with some friends. And I'll mention again, as I have many times before, the friends we make and the people we meet is by far the best part of being out here cruising. Mama's like, move along, people. Ooh, there it is. Wow. That's so pretty. Wow.
So this guy just came flying down the water slide. Maybe he's gonna do it again. Oh my gosh. I think I gotta try that. Are those piranhas?
I think they're piranhas.
Good. Oh, you are. That's awesome.
I'm just falling to my arm.
Yeah. Yeah, Mike, haven't you seen Dirty Dancing?
We were so close.
Why, yes, I can.
Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear, it's a truth.
And I'm nobody puts Cheryl in a corner.
Thank you. Thanks for watching Season 4 of Fun on Holiday in the crazy year that was 2020. It's hard to believe that less than a year ago, we were just leaving Fajardo, Puerto Rico. We spent some magical months in the Spanish, U.S., and British Virgin Islands before we started hearing about this crazy thing called the coronavirus, which put us on a total lockdown in St. Martin, then forced us on a three-day passage to Grenada, where we finished the season loving life in this strange new world. We hope that you enjoyed watching it all as much as we enjoyed sharing it with you. We'll be back for Season 5, where we'll attempt to manage coronavirus travel restrictions, starting with heading north to St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Okay, we've been back in Woburn for about a month now. Whoops, let's start that over.
I am weak. I need you to go.
Sorry.
Sorry.
It was a really
slipping.
It was a really good shot. Whoa! You scared me.